He is a part-time resident of Brooklyn who fearlessly roots for the Red Sox. He rose from selling food out of his living room to cooking for national television audiences.
And now, says Erica, this colorful character lands in Vermont, bringing life to the old family farm.
Here in Londonderry, yes, there are bed and breakfasts and inns you can choose from, but there are also some really unique and beautiful rental properties. So I want to introduce you to the owner of a couple of them who actually has Boston roots. I've known Ben Sargent for years from summers on Cape Cod. He grew up in Cambridge. Now Ben spends his time between Vermont and Brooklyn.
So Ben, tell me about the property itself. Give me kind of a rundown of the history. I know it was in your family.
So it was my mother and my stepfather's dream. They came up here and decided they were going to be horse farmers, which they did really well and had a great time doing it. My mom passed away, and this place at a certain point became my responsibility.
So Ben dug in and took on the farm, making it his own.
I got rid of the horses, and then I was left with all these buildings, all these structures that served no purpose anymore. So it was like slowly but surely, I just started like working on each one.
The main farmhouse on the property is a popular rental on Airbnb with 5 bedrooms, all with spectacular views, a chef's kitchen, and plenty of room to relax.
That's more for the family, and it has everything you need. It's sort of got the like Martha Stewart thing. And so people tell, they're like, oh my God, you know, we thought we had to bring up salt and pepper and olive oil. And they're like, you have a better stock kitchen than we have at home. And so to me, that's really rewarding. I like to feel like people are going away with a nice experience.
Authentic, traditional New England clam chowder.
Some may know him as the Brooklyn Chowder Surfer. He once sold lobster rolls out of his apartment.
Love the Boston Bed!
And if he looks familiar, that's because he's been cooking seafood on television for years. Back to the farm, besides the main house, there are other smaller spaces he's fixed up.
So what was this?
This was an equipment shed. It was just a dirt floor. There was nothing.
With 1 bedroom, the shed boasts an open floor plan. He then moved on to the running shed.
And it literally was where the horses would come in and eat. And that's for like your backpacker, like a couple who's like, they really love the rustic thing. You know, I show them how to work the wood burning stove and they leave, and it's not expensive.
All right, you have a secret to show me.
Yeah, so this is behind the little spice rack here. Like that. All right, we're in the garage now.
Okay.
And it's a 1972 F350. People are always like, oh, you said that there was like extra beds in here and there's no extra beds. I'm like,
Young and full of energy, there's a reason Sargent balances urban and country living.
I actually find myself being more busy here, but sometimes I'll stop and I'll be like chipping paint, like scraping paint off the side of the house. And I'll be like, what am I doing? I am way too young for this. I'm a single guy up in Vermont where I will meet nobody. I'm like, this is ridiculous. And so then I climb down. I'm like, gotta go.
Come on, Joey. Good boy, Joey.
These dogs may be barking and whining, but they have good reason. Like top athletes, they live to run.
They're going crazy, barking, and once they go, they're just quiet. They're just in their happy place.
Good boys, let's go, good boys.
Corey White is owner and musher of Green Mountain Mushers. The dogs carefully selected for each position.
And these are lead dogs right here. This is Clyde, and this is Tonto.
Hi.
The lead dogs have a little more focus.
Look at these eyes on Tonto. I mean, like, so we got the brains and the brawn.
Exactly, yeah, and then,
right?
And these guys are the point dogs.
Okay.
They're like backup lead dogs.
Okay.
And Joey's in the swing dog position right now. The swing dog helps keep the team from cutting corners too sharp. And the wheel dogs are right in the back. They're right in front of the sled, and they're the strongest dogs. And they initially get the sled moving. They're the main strength.
The dogs are Siberian and Alaskan Huskies.
Boy.
Don't let their scrappy looks fool you. They're a breed for speed.
They can go up to close to 30 miles an hour, and they love it. They want to go as fast and as hard as they can all the time.
Tell me about the tours that you do here at Stratton.
So we do tours every day from 4 to 9 p.m. here. We run right out on the Nordic trails. It's about a 3-mile loop through the woods. And we wait till the ski area closes, so all skiers are off the trails. And then most of the tours are at night in the dark, and we use a headlamp, the stars and moon. It's a real, real cool experience, real fun.
Boys.
Yeah, beautiful. Dog sledding's fun. I've done it a few times. Those particular sleds hold two adults or two children and one adult or three children, all depending, of course, on size and your family configuration.
Yeah, and if you're going to do it, Erica says dress warmly because as soon as it gets dark and those cute little pups take off, they take off very quickly and it gets really, really cold.
All right, his treasures are literally made from trash.
Well, I make a wall hanging sculpture out of barn board from old barns.